following distance. As we're driving down the highway, this is what we saw. Your driver up the tail of this other truck. They're not going that slow. We're gonna move over to the right. But it really doesn't matter how slow or fast you're going. That's a terrible following distance. You just wanna let that truck come on by. There's a mile marker 302. And he's still with this. Stevens right here. That's less than one. About 5'3" is what I'm coming up with. Or you can check it yourself. When you see that shadow line, leave a white line. See when the other shadow line of your truck reaches that same white line. Half a second right here at 62 miles an hour. Gonna move over to the right one more time. Gonna let another truck come on by. Back over to the left. He's gotta come on out now. Let's plenty of room to come. That is a close lane change. He really waited for that timing there on that. Here, come up, get a truck number for you. And that's how you end up in rear end collisions. Something jumps out in front of that Stevens, a deer or something like that. Pow, you hit it. That's it. You can't do anything more than hit that brake pedal. That's it. Some drivers say they've been driving for years and they know how to do this and that. And if they did, they wouldn't be in a situation like that. Not a true professional. And there are some trucks you don't want to tailgate because they have what's called an on-guard braking system. And that on-guard braking system will automatically actuate the brakes without the driver knowing it, even the driver. So if something were 22378, so even if the driver were to travel down the road and something jumped out in front of them, those brakes would actuate, and then who's ever behind them gonna get, well, rear-end them. It's called OnGuard, you can look it up. I know Crete's been dabbling with them. 12:21 is your date and time, today's the 8th.